Hi folks, Lance from Runtime Recruitment. Hope you're having a fantastic day wherever you are in the world. Operating systems, do you need one in embedded systems or not? You know, a lot of the times you don't need an operating system. Depends on the complexity of the application. Most embedded systems are normally on very low spec CPUs with limited resources, and a super loop and interrupts can normally do the trick. But in more sophisticated applications and embedded systems are becoming more and more complex as we move through time, there is a need to have some sort of a kernel. So there are lots of RTOSs out there, including free RTOS, which seems to be very, very popular. As you can see from this chart, 18% of the people that are surveyed are using free RTOS. But embedded Linux is the king here. Embedded Linux is taking the lead here at 21%, mainly because it's small enough and you can compile it to a really small size and customize it to whatever you want. You can add in all the bells and whistles if you want for a really comprehensive kernel, or you can take all of that out and you can have a very, very small kernel for your embedded system. Hence the lead at 21%. And also there's a huge community behind it and it's open source. There's no licensing fees, etc. So not surprisingly, embedded Linux has taken the lead. However, there are lots of other operating systems that people are still using. And surprisingly, Windows 10 is in this chart at 10%, which is a bit of a surprise. And then you have these other RTOSs which have been around a long, long time, including Wind River with VxWorks, Integrity with Green Hills, UCOS, which I used in my first project when I was an engineer starting off, and so on. There's a lot of different operating systems still around and still being used. What are your thoughts? Do you need a kernel? Have you used a kernel when you started a new project? Or do you think it's a little bit of an overkill? Leave your comments in the comments field and let's have a chat. See you in the next one.